Make haste, O God, to deliver me.
Make haste to help me, O Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, it is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, because his mercy endureth forever. Let Israel now say, let his mercy endureth forever. That his mercy endureth forever.
I call upon the Lord in distress. The Lord answered me and set me in a large place.
The Lord is on my side, I will not fear. What can man do unto me? Trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes.
Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning.
I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. All nations compassed me about, but in the name of the Lord will I destroy them.
They compass me about, yea, they compass me about. But in the name of the Lord I will destroy them.
They compass me about like bees. They are quenched as the fire of thorns. For in the name of the Lord I will destroy them.
Thou hast thrust sore and he hath had my fall. But the Lord helped me.
my salvation.
The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tabernacles of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord will do their valiantly.
The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord do it valiantly.
I shall not lie but live, and declare the works of the Lord.
The Lord hath chastened me sore, but he hath not given me over unto death.
Glory be to the Father and to the Son.
This is the gate of the Lord.
World without end. Amen.
from John, the second chapter. On the third day there was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus also was invited to the wedding with his disciples. When the wine ran out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what does this have to do with me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the master of the feast." So they took it. When the master of the feast tasted the water now become wine, and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and when the people have drunk freely, then the poor wine. But you have kept the good wine until now." This, the first of his signs, Jesus did at Cana in Galilee, and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us.
Thanks be to thee, O Lord.
I will pay my vows unto the courts of the house of the Lord.
I will pay my vows unto the Lord. In the courts of the house of the Lord.
I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord.
In the courts of the house of the Lord.
Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost.
I will pay my vows unto the Lord. In the courts of the house of the Lord.
A writing from Valerius Hairbearer. O Lord Jesus, such is your manner from of old. He to whom you wish to show great grace must first wrestle with you and face great tribulation. All human help must first vanish. Only after weeping did the wine appear, as at the marriage in Cana. Dear Mary had to wrestle with you. You made your appearance, as it were, stern and unkind, refusing to make any certain promise. But when she trusted in your goodness, she obtained a great miracle. O Lord Jesus, though you may not make a certain promise, yet you do not exclude the possibility. You know well what time is best. I will trust in you. Your will is my will. Come not when I will, but when you will. Your will is best of all. Help me in humility to wait for your timing. O Lord Jesus, I will be content with your dear mother's last words in the Bible, her last testament. She said, "Whatever the Lord says to you, do it." I honor her with obedience to her words, by which she has directed me to you alone. And I come to you with my weary heart, for you plainly said and instructed as much, and I am certain in my heart that in this way I will stand before you at the last judgment. This is, moreover, the will of your Father also. Listen to him. O Lord Jesus, help me willingly to do whatever you say. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has drawn near. O grant that I may not conclude my life in unrepentance. You say, watch and pray. O help me to act and walk cautiously, and to sigh and pray heartily at all times. You say, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. O grant grace that I may take comfort in you in true faith, that I may use the most worthy sacrament often, and not esteem lightly your command, do this in remembrance of me. You say, this is my commandment, that you love one another. O direct me, that I may exhibit a kind heart toward my neighbor. You say, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. O help me to honor you with obedience, to bear my cross willingly at your pleasure, and so to remain steadfast in obedience to you until my end. Finally, take me into everlasting life, where I will do forever what you say, and serve you in eternal righteousness, innocence, and holiness. O Lord Jesus, you will not leave any among your believing Christians empty-handed. We are all to receive of your fullness. We are all to extol your generosity. My God, how shall we ever thank you enough for this gift? Every year you will turn water, and you still turn water into wine. The vine takes in the rainwater, and your almighty power miraculously transforms the rainwater into delicious wine. You have power over all creation. You are Lord over nature. From water you can make both blood and wine. Blood to vex your enemies, wine to gladden your friends. O Jesus Christ, I will commend my body and soul to your protection, and all nature must serve me, even contrary to its normal ways. I believe it in my heart, for your word teaches me so. O let me also know of it indeed. Here ends the writing.
O boundless wisdom, God Most High,
bless me, the untempered.
worship thee, O God.
As he prays to thy name, O Lord,
my spirit hath rejoiced in God, my Savior, for he hath regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God, God my Savior.
For he hath regarded the state of his handmaiden.
For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed.
For he that is mighty hath done to me great things.
From generation to generation,
he has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts.
He hath put down the mighty from their seats and exalted them of low degree.
He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent empty away.
He hath opened his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy,
as he said to our fathers, to thy will be done on earth as it is.
govern all things in heaven and earth. Mercifully hear the supplications of thy people, and grant us thy peace all the days of our life. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
O God, who makest all things to work together for good to them that love thee, pour into our hearts such steadfast love toward thee, that the pure desires which by thy Spirit have been stirred up in us may not be turned aside by any temptation. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that we, being defended by thee from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness. Through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.